Hi everybody, today is our topic how Indian economy classified on the basis of terms of ownership. On the basis of terms of ownership, Indian economy classified into public sector and private sector. Public sector and private sector. Let us discuss what is public sector and private sector. So, public sector, what is public sector? In public sector, government owns most of the assets and provide all the services. So, government own all the assets are owned by government and all the services are provided by government. That is called the public sector. All the assets are owned and services are provided by government. So what about in private sector? In private sector, all the assets are owned by private individual or company and all the services are delivered by private individual or company. So all the assets are owned and all the services are delivered by private individual or private companies. That is known as private sector. All the assets owned and services are delivered by individual or private companies. This is called the private sector. So in public sector, all the assets are owned and all the services are provided by government. But in private sector, all the assets are owned and the services are delivered by individual or private companies. Then we will look which are the examples for public sector and private sector. So public sector, many examples you can tell: railway, post office, SRTC, government hospitals, schools, government schools, health centers. So many examples we can tell. I am writing two examples here: railway, post office, KCB. Many examples we can tell. BSNL. Okay, so two examples I wrote here: railway and post office. Then private sector also we know many examples: Reliance, Jio, Nokia, Samsung, like that. Many private companies are the vehicle, many motor vehicle companies are many examples we can tell. Then Tata, Tisco, what's the full form of Tisco? Tata Iron and Steel Company Limited. So these all are examples for private sector. So here two examples I am writing. One is Reliance and Tisco, Tata Iron and Steel Company Limited. Reliance Industries Limited or RIL. Then Tisco, Tata Iron and Steel Company Limited. So these are example for private sector. If we are looking about private sector, you know many activities I told. So these all activities we can tell. What will be the aim of private companies for an individual? What will be the aim of providing these all services? Profit maximization. So their main target will be profit maximization in the private sector. If you are looking about public sector, not only the profit maximization, they in private sector will give importance to the welfare of the people. So these all services mainly for giving welfare, give more importance to the welfare of the people, not only profit maximization. It will give importance to the welfare of the people. So this is the difference between public sector and the private sector. I think you got an idea about the public sector and the private sector. Anyway, you know government is providing many services for us. So government, from where government is getting money? for giving these old services, government is collecting taxes. So this taxes, to meet all these expenses, government is collecting taxes. So that is the revenue of the government. There are several things needed by the society as a whole. So there are many things we needed. Society as a whole, many people living together in a society. So as a society as a whole, we needed many things. So private sector will not provide at a reasonable cost all these things. Private sector can't give at a reasonable cost, because some of the things needed very large sums of money. Many of the services or many of the things needed large amount of money, which beyond the capacity of private sector. So if they are providing such types of things or such types of services to us, means they will charge very high rate of money, very high cost they will charge for such type of services. So some type of services such as the construction of roads, bridges, railway, harbors, electricity, irrigation through dams, that and all the responsibility of government. So these all responsibility government took. So it, because it need heavy spending, so government is ensure these all services, whether these all services available for everyone, that everything will look after by government, and government affording the price, that through all these services are provided by government, and government is affording the price for providing all these services, and government will look after whether all these services are getting or ensuring these services getting to every individual or not. Now we can look some other activities. There are some other activities which need government support, which need government support. Otherwise, private sector can't continue their production without government encourage it. For example, we can tell many industries are the private sector doing many industries. These all industries needed electricity. If government is not providing electricity at affordable price means it will be very difficult for the private companies to continue their production. So government is affording some cost, government is bearing some cost and giving support to these type of private industries, and government is encouraging this type of industries. Another example, we can tell government of India buys wheat and rice from the farmers at a fair price. So government is giving a fair price to the farmers and buying wheat and rice. And same rice and wheat is giving through ration shop to the consumers. So the consumers getting this wheat and rice at a cheaper rate. So the government is taking, bearing some cost, and government is supporting both the farmers and the consumers, those who are consuming that items, rice and wheat, they are getting at a cheap rate. So government is supporting both the farmers and the consumers, and government is affording or bearing the cost. Another example, we can tell government is providing better health facilities and education for everybody. That also the responsibility of government, giving proper education, running proper school, providing quality of education, that everything are the duty of the government. And providing better health facilities, that also another important duty of the government. Still, you know, illiteracy is an important problem in India. Many states in India, we can tell, if you are looking in the case of literacy rate, they are below. So what is literacy means? At least a person want to know read and write any one language, then we can tell that person are literate. So literacy, government is providing proper attention to the health and education. Still, literacy is an important problem in India. Nearly half of India's children are malnourished and a quarter of them are critically ill. Many people are malnourished and many are critically ill. And if you are checking the infant mortality rate, that also high in some many states in India, infant mortality rate is high. So what is infant mortality rate means? Number of infant deaths for every 1,000 live births, that is called infant mortality rate. If you are checking the infant mortality rate, we can tell many states in India, infant mortality rate is high. like Odisha, Madhya Pradesh, etc. So these two are the two important states having high infant mortality rate. Then we can tell Assam, another state having infant mortality rate. Comparing with all other state, infant mortality rate is very low in Kerala because of the improved health facility. Infant mortality rate is very less in Kerala. And if you are looking the infant mortality rate, current infant mortality rate, it is 28.3%. So current, if you are checking the 2019 data, what about the infant mortality rate in India? 28.3%. So government is taking many steps for giving better nutrition to the children also. So you know, you already learned midday meal program, that is for elementary schools, government school, elementary children are getting cooked lunch. So that is called midday meal program. This is also why this midday meal program started. That also for providing nutritional or improving the nutritional value among the children. So you already learned in the last class what is midday meal program. Midday meal program that first started in Tamil Nadu. After that, this program, the Supreme Court given an order to start all the states of India this midday meal program. So the elementary school children are getting cooked lunch. So through this, many benefits are there. Children are malnourished, that can avoid malnourishment, or children will get nutritional value, and at the same time school enrollment will increase. Many Dalit women will get job, cooking lunch, that also giving some job opportunity to the Dalit woman. So many benefits also there. So this is one steps taken by government for improving the nutritional value among the children. Now you know children are getting many kit from the schools and all, know providing. Now school is closed, so we know they are getting some kit, food kit, that also for providing nutritional value to the children. Besides all this, we can tell government is taking many steps for providing the safe drinking water, availability of safe drinking water, housing facilities for the poor, and food and nutrition, that all are the responsibility of government, and taking care of the poorest and most ignored region, poorest and the most ignored region of the country, through increased spending in such type of areas. That also government is taking many steps. So these are some steps taken by government for providing better services. Okay, so these all are the services, public sector providing services. I think this topic is clear to you. So this much only, this chapter. I think this chapter is clear to you. If you have any doubt, ask me. We will meet in the next class.